Burns Avenue Southall, the location of a third raid by the anti-terrorist squad since the beginning of the week. Officers watched the house from a property across the street. At least two women have been arrested under the Prevention of Terrorism Act.
We heard a banging noise. When we looked outside, and the police were forcing the door down, and we just told to go inside. And so we just looked up from outside, and we just saw the girls being led outside after about an hour. They were wearing white suits, like forensic suits, and they were just escorted into cars and driven off, and the police just sealed the whole area off and just told everybody to stay inside.
Three men are still being held at the top security Paddington Green police station following two other raids. Armed police stormed addresses in Hanwell and Cheshunt, seizing arms and bomb-making equipment. The undercover operation is thought to have swung into action 5 weeks ago, when detectives identified a new IRA gang at work on the mainland. This afternoon, Scotland Yard confirmed arrests had been made and that a very large quantity of explosives, bomb-making equipment and munitions have been seized following a tip-off from a member of the public. The man sold a van to a cash buyer who he thought was acting suspiciously. It's understood police have intercepted three vans, one containing bomb parts rather than a huge device. In May, responsibility for gathering intelligence on the IRA was handed to the security service MI5. Terrorism experts believe this could be the key to this week's breakthrough.
And I think what has happened is that there's been a greater success in getting advance intelligence of the movements of terrorists, which has enabled them to actually follow the workings of this cell, the way in which they dealt with the quartermaster who provides accommodation and vehicles, and that is a considerable breakthrough for the police on the mainland.
This evening, all the terrorist suspects are still being held at Paddington Green police station. Still being held at Paddington Green police station.